Hello guys, good morning, welcome to the session. Yes, we'll start. In last class, let me go here. Yeah, we have been talking about the database. We talked about MySQL, DynamoDB, and also we have been discussing about CloudWatch, right? So CloudWatch is a monitoring tool. By default, if you create any service, you'll get CloudWatch monitoring. So let me go to EC2. Okay, let us start this instance. Right, we will be having this monitoring. See, cloud monitoring will be there and all these metrics, CPU utilization, status check, and network input, network out, disk read, etc. And if you want a CloudWatch for your EC2 related to your memory utilization and other things, then you have to install CloudWatch agent on EC2 instance. Okay, AWS says that they will monitor some metrics like CPU utilization, status checks, networks, disk write operations, all these things, but they will not get into your EC2 instance. So they will not check the memory utilizations, and that means checking memory utilization means your applications will be using your memory utilization. So if you want detailed monitoring on some metrics related to EC2, you should install CloudWatch agent. Say CPU utilization, if I want to manage detailed monitoring, say detailed monitoring enable. So this will enable detailed monitoring, and Amazon EC2 console displays monitoring graphs. So by default, monitoring is there for all the services. However, if you have a lot, so many services within your system, if you want to monitor all of them, and CloudWatch is the place where you can do that. Can create alarms, you can watch, you can trigger some actions also. Let's go here. Dashboard. Right, in last class we have created a dashboard. Choose actions. Okay, add widget. Metrics and EC2 is here, per instance metrics. Right, same things which we have seen in the monitoring section, same things will be there. CPU utilization, create widget, right? So after some time, just now I have started EC2, so after some time we will see the CPU utilization here, CPU utilization graph, and also alarms. We have talked about alarms, and while doing auto scaling groups also, we have discussed this alarms. You can say create alarm. Yesterday we have created one alarm, I have deleted it, and then log groups. You can log data here. And using this CloudWatch log group, you can get log insights. Not only that, using CloudWatch log group, you can trigger events and actions. So before talking about log groups, so the name itself says log groups means it will log details of your access towards the services, say S3. You have created S3, added object in S3, then edited permissions of that object. After that, few people access that object from the S3. So all these are logs related towards S3 access. So if you want to log all these details in the log groups, yes, you can create a log group. And we also have CloudTrail. Yesterday we have discussed about CloudTrail too. CloudTrail track user activity and API usage. Just give me a minute, guys. Right. See, CloudTrail by default monitors all the events. I have started instances. Right, I have started my EC2 instance. And before that, I have logged into the console. And these are yesterday logs. Right, so you can download events and you can create CloudTrail. Let's go back. Create a CloudTrail, or you can go to dashboard, create trail from here. Yesterday we have created one CloudTrail which logs management events. Let us create one more trail. So from here also you can create your CloudWatch log group. CloudTrail. So CloudTrail logs the things happening in AWS. And AWS calls them as events. Some change happening to AWS existing status is called as events. So all the events will be logged in event history and it's there. However, if you want to save those logs, maybe after 6 months, your company does auditing and they will analyze the AWS access, etc., and they'll get some insights, optimize the usage, cost optimization, etc. So for all these things, you need these logs. And anyway, CloudTrail by default is logging. But that logs will be available for only 14 days. After 14 days, logs will automatically get deleted. If you want to save these logs, then you should create a CloudTrail. We will call it as management events. And then we will go with create new S3 bucket, where it will save all these logs in a S3 bucket. S3 bucket named AWS CloudTrail logs, something like this. So all CloudTrail logs, it will save there. And then we don't want KMS and SNS notification delivery. If some event happen, you can write set SNS, you'll get notification. And CloudWatch logs, it's optional. if you enable this, it will also save the same data in cloud watch logs with the name cloud trail logs. So what is difference between this? So anyhow, when I create this cloud trail, it logs all the details in this S3 bucket. And why I need CloudWatch logs too? Already CloudTrail logs is there. Why? Because CloudTrail log allows you to just save the logs in a S3 bucket. And CloudWatch logs not only saves the logs, it allows you to take some actions, monitor the logs, get insights from the logs. So that's why CloudWatch logs are helpful. And with the same name, a CloudWatch log group will also be created. See, so the same name. This number is different. And then I am role new. That's it. Let's say next. AWS. We don't want KMS. That is encryption. Role. I have created a new role, right? So it has to create a new role. Next. New role. Why in role? We already know what role is. Now, CloudTrail is a different service. This one. CloudWatch is a different service. Now, CloudTrail writes into cloud logs. So we need a role. So role is there. Role, I have chosen new means it will exist. It will create a new role with required policies. And next. Okay, let us create role and attach here. It has to automatically create one, but why? Anyway, duplicate. I am. By default, some service is there. AWS service role for CloudWatch events. Let us look into this. This is CloudWatch event service role policy. And CloudWatch permissions is limited. It's only read. Let's go back. Create a role. Create a role for CloudTrail. Next, permissions. By default, we are getting this cloud trail service role policy. Let's see. Cloud trail full access. Next tags, create role. Not this one, we want us, we want cloud trail to access cloud access. So create a role once again. For cloud trail. Cloud watch, log groups, cloud watch events is there. Okay, next permissions. Okay, we have this role anyway. Let's say cloud trail service role, and then so since this is a service role, we cannot edit. Let's call this as management. So enable log group and new. Okay, next. Okay, let's say next. See here, management events, data events, and insight events. Management events, we already discussed. So capture management operations, data events, log the resource operations. Whereas insights will give like if there is any unusual activity errors or unusual user behavior in the account, then insight events will get created. So by default, management events will be there. These management events means creation of any services, read operations, write operations, all these things. We already discussed management events, data events. Suppose we are creating S3 bucket, it's a management event. And if you upload object into the S3 bucket, it's a data event. And now you have made that object public and you have added tags to that object. The things related to the objects which is inside your S3 bucket are data events, whereas you have edited the bucket policy, made bucket public, created another replica of your S3 bucket, copied the bucket, all these things are management events. So by default, management events are there. Management events are free in a free trail, but data events, there will be charge for data events. And coming to insight events. See, these insight events, if you want to detect any unusual activity, errors, or user behavior, suppose if you take EC2, the normal traffic flow of EC2 is different. Suddenly, a lot of traffic is coming in. So much of traffic, maybe it can be DDoS attack, or certain user operations has been increased, then these insights events will push a notification or raise an alarm. So let us go to management events. And next, create trail. Previously, I have created this one. Now we have created management events. This time, we have also chosen CloudWatch log groups. So this is the CloudWatch log group. For this, I have not selected CloudWatch log group. So now let's go to CloudWatch. See the CloudTrail log group which we have. So now all the CloudTrail logs will be there in CloudWatch. This is a CloudWatch log group. If you want to create a log group of certain service, you can also do that. Say for example, VPC is there. I want to know the logs related to VPC. Create flow log. Let's call VPC flow log. The type of traffic to capture. Let's say all. Maximum aggregation interval. We can leave it at default. Send to CloudWatch logs or send to Amazon SC, we will say send to CloudWatch logs. Destination log group. So yesterday I have created one log group. I am choosing that one. I am role. Okay, I have to create this I am role under no option of creating here itself. AWS service role for cloud trail, cloud watch events. Let's go and create one role. Create a role. Want VPC allows try to send these use cases are there. I cannot go for next. CloudWatch. So we will choose AWS service role for CloudWatch events. And then create flow log. Okay, and then go back to CloudWatch. Log groups and cloud log. So now all the data related to VPC. So traffic coming into the VPC, traffic going out of the VPC will be logged here. So you can also log details related to specific service. And then we have events. And we know already what events is, and you can write rules. And these rules, based on the events, you can trigger some action. These rules triggers those actions. Let us create a rule, you will understand. Event pattern, you can also schedule the events. First we will see event pattern. Service name, we have all these things. So let's say EC2. Event type, EC2 instance, state change notifications from running to stop or stop to termination, running to termination. If there is any state change, you'll get a notification. EBS volume notification. If we want EBS volume to get used only within the limits, then we can set an EBS notification. Here we will use AWS API call via CloudTrail. We already discussed about CloudTrail. CloudTrail is monitoring all the events. So I'll set a specific operation. And if that operation meets, CloudTrail has to make an API call. Based on that, I'll add trigger. Say, what is that specific operation? related to EC2.